You had light, that's crazy.
It isn't right to tease a fool. It isn't right the way I lose my cool. So Chico Hamilton was a legend, a famous jazz drummer and band leader. He's really famous for like having a pianoless group and the whole like West Coast sound that like we think of Chet Baker and those guys. It was really from Chico starting it. And he put on a lot of people like Eric Dolphy, people who were like really radical in their ideas. That was his whole thing. He taught me, because I recorded with him when I was a student at the New School, and we did a duet with just drums and voice, which really was crazy because he's a legend. And he did it with Tony Bennett. It was the same. It was Lazy Afternoon. And he was like, I want you to do it with you. And I was like, oh my God, this is crazy. So we did one take, you know, and me being like the young student, I was like, we got to do another one right away. And he was like, we could, you know, but he said that all the emotions in the first take, he's like, the second take is going to be more technically perfect, maybe, but all the feeling is in the first one. So he's like, you got to choose between like the heart or like the mind sort of. And that's really stuck with me. So I try to perform rather than record always.
Once I left in love.
There's something honest about like the first reaction you have to anything when you try on a jacket for the first time and you're like, oh, like, wow, this makes me feel, you know what I mean? It's the same thing, you know, and then maybe a friend will say, I don't know, that's not your color. And then your mind says, maybe it's not my color. But that feeling that you have, that's what I always go for. And it's the same with writing a song like St. James, you know, which for a lot of my fans, I think was a bit different than what they're used to. They're used to me doing like jazz or R&B. And this is more of like a kind of, I'd call it singer-songwriter. But that's a big part of me too, you know? And I think any artist should strive to be holistic in what they give. You know, like Prince gave us a lot of funk, but he also had these cool ballads and he also had these cool like other sides of him that maybe weren't like the hits, but were part of his world. Yeah, I have so many influences. You know, Marvin Gaye is a huge one because he sort of, well, there's like a secret about a lot of R&B singers of his generation and before, like Al Green, people like that. They actually started in jazz. They sang jazz because that's what the music was. And if you wanted to get a gig, you'd have to sing in a supper club and you'd have to learn some standards and pop songs at the time. We're talking about like the 50s and 60s, you know? So I look at him as this kind of like linchpin figure between like Nat King Cole and like early jazz guys, who he loved, you know, and then like D'Angelo, like he's like in between both of them. And when you listen to his music, him or Quincy Jones or anybody who came out of that like Ray Charles jazz influenced stuff, you can hear all the jazz voicings and the chords. Even though it's not jazz, the harmony's there.
I paid the price for your love and I take all the blame.
I was on tour and, you know, played like a long 2-hour show or something. And, you know, after a show, you get really like amped up. You can't sleep, you know, so it's like 1 a.m. And usually like that time, I think I was in Europe. It wasn't 3, but when I finished, it was probably 3. And, you know, I just started playing that. I just had that line, those two chords, and that da 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 da, and I think it just created this mood, and it made me think of actually Crosby, Stills, and Nash, you know, and some of their kind of like early records, you know, that had this like soulful but folk feel. To me, that is so evocative always. You know, it's like something falling, but it's also like getting warm. Like it doesn't feel sad. It's like when the leaves start to fall in autumn. That's what that change sounds to me. So that puts me in a mood, you know, right away. I've never written lyrics first for some reason, because I don't know, for me, I don't think there's a wrong way to do it, but the vibe of the, like, I have to build the house. I think of like the words as like furniture, you know what I mean? I think of like the song is like empty space and like the structure, you know, and then you like decorate it with, you know what I mean, with words. And you're like, what's the best word? You're like, okay. And Tali co-wrote that song with me. You know, she wrote the hook, you know, because she's really good at that. And I think it's a good balance between perspectives.
Say what you need to be me, know you, me.
I mean, it needed a woman's touch, you know. My house would be all just like modern and cold, you know. No, I mean, I think it's good to co-write things. I think it's important to get somebody else's perspective. And Tali really understands my writing. So now what I do is I sort of take it as far as I'm able to go. And St. James actually has some of my favorite lyrics I've ever written. You know, like in the last verse, I say, let's have a coffee and let's smoke one more cigarette. You've heard all my stories. You're somehow not sick of me yet. Like, I love lines like that because I feel like there's something so like casual about like breakups. Like usually you do something mundane, like you're like, you go to a coffee shop and you have a cup of coffee, or you talk about it, you go to brunch, you know what I mean? There's something like really like mundane about that, that I kind of like, you know, that's like loaded with all of this like deep feeling. But there's always like a scene of a couple at a cafe in a movie, right? I always write about like, it could be a relationship, but it could be me talking to myself, or it could be me talking to God, you know? Yeah, I also like the once I laughed and loved and called your name kind of idea, where it's like you see someone on like Instagram that you used to be so close with, and now they're like strangers, and you like realize like, wow, I really used to, we had a thing, you know? That to me is one of the strangest moments in like human relations, where you're like, yo, that was my best friend. Like, yeah, what happened? Like, that's been 7 years. And then you have that feeling like, should we get coffee? Smoke one last cigarette, like for old times? Like, I love all those old, like one for the road, like for the good times, like those kind of things, because I think they sum up these like places where we meet, not only physically, but like, you know, just for a moment to like share something. And, you know, I think there's something that becomes charged later. Like when you think back, like, wow, like the last time I saw them, we were, you know, in Paris at this cafe. I keep coming to this image, you know, but that really helps me to kind of like encapsulate a moment, you know, without giving away too much, because I want to leave space for the listener to bring in their own feelings and kind of think like, oh, how does it make me feel? The acoustic guitar had to be part of it, because it has this like, if you're not strumming, like finger picking just sounds like sad. It sounds sad, you know? And I love that kind of like 70s vibe with like the Rhodes and guitar and everything feeling very like warm. It's like warm and happy sad, you know? It's like equally happy and sad.
Once I laughed in love and called your name.
I'm probably not self-critical enough, honestly. I sort of say, this is where I am right now, and it's as good as I am. and that's what it is, you know. And I try not to look back. I usually only listen to a song like once or twice to make sure I like it, and I put it out in the world and I'm like, it doesn't belong to me anymore, it belongs to you. And Miles Davis said this too. It's like, if you believe the good reviews, then you have to believe the bad ones too. And I didn't understand what that meant until I started getting some bad reviews. And I was like, oh, I see, you know. And I knew on St. James, I said, you know, for me, I think this is some of my best writing, my best lyrics. The form itself is very simple. It's not complicated, which I like too. But I was like, I think the story is really good. And I took it as far as I could, and then I gave it to Tali, and then she, you know, gave me the hook, and I was like, all right, this is done.
But let me say my every.
When I grew up in Minneapolis, right? And no one I knew had a passport at all. Like, no one I knew, none of the kids I went to school with traveled. And I don't even mean like internationally. I'm talking about like no one went to New York. It was a big deal to go to Chicago, which is like a 1 hour flight away. That's like, whoa, Chicago. See what I mean? So for me to be like, you know, to have this career and to be recognized in like Sao Paulo or Tokyo, like if I walk around in Tokyo, people recognize me on the street. Yo, Jose James. I mean, that blows my mind. And I'm not like, you know, Beyonce, but like even for me, for to be this kid, to be able to go to like Seoul or like, you know, anywhere, even Amsterdam, you know, to be recognized for my art is like such a huge gift. It's not about a goal. It's not like a Grammy or like a thing. It's more about like, what's my contribution to culture, you know? And then you have to ask yourself, well, then who are you? And that's like, I think that's the hard question that art forces you to look at, you know?
It's finished, it's over, it's time to get out of the rain. Finally sober, but I need a high for this pain. Once I laughed in love and called your name, I had to choose from the drugs and the bottle and fame. It's 3 in the morning and I'm still awake reaching out, stuck on the shape of your body, the taste of your mouth. Once I laughed in love and called your name, but I rolled the dice and I lost on your love all the same. Say what you need to mean it, no. Never been good at goodbye, but let me say my every heart I hold, I break. Every heart I hold, I bring. Let's have a coffee and let's smoke one more cigarette. You heard all my stories and somehow not sick of me yet. Once I laughed and loved and called your name, but I paid the price for your love and I take all the blame. Say what you need to, scream it, know you mean it. I'm not trying to make you stay. I've never been good at goodbye, but let me say my every heart I hold, I we'll travel through.